I am your science teacher. Be ready with your textbook. And today's good words are eat healthy food. So everybody should eat healthy food. Now it may not show the result for you, but when you grow up, when you after 10 to 15 years, it shows the good result in your body. Then help your siblings, maybe your elder brother or sister or younger brother or sister. You must help them in the daily activities like in studying or helping in household activities. You can help them. So these are the two good things which I want to tell you today. Now going into the lesson, are you ready with your term book? The things required are your term book. And in the recap, we have learned about reproduction through various body parts, that is through stem, through roots and leaves, as well as spores. So about these we have discussed in the previous lesson. Now today we are going to learn about the crops and vegetables. What are the different kinds of crops and what are the different vegetables? And we will also learn about kinds of crops. So there are two or three types of crops, and which grow according to the season, based on the soil. So about these things we are going to learn today. Now you have to open page number 285. Open page 285 and be ready. So in the previous lesson we have learned about reproduction through stem. The best examples are potato, onion, ginger, rose, hibiscus. So hibiscus, rose and bougainvillea. Bougainvillea is the plants which you see on the roadside, okay? The pink colored, white colored flowers and orange colored flowers. So the flowers will be of different colors. So these are the examples of stem cutting. And the next one is reproduction from roots. The examples are carrot, radish and sweet potato. So these are the examples of reproduction through roots. Then reproduction through leaves, and the best example is bryophyllum. To the edges of the leaves, the plants are going to again make buds, which again they follow up with the roots. And the last one is reproduction through spores, and the examples are moles, mushrooms and fern plants. Okay, so these plants, they do not have flowers or fruits to reproduce. So in these plants, what happens? These plants bear spores. So through these spores, they reproduce. And today we are going to learn about crops and vegetables. So open page 285. A plant that is grown in large quantities on a large commercial scale, especially a cereal, fruit or vegetable, is called a crop. The practice of growing crops for food and other purposes is called agriculture. So in our home we grow crops, isn't it? For suppose a chili plant is there, one or two plants we grow. Or if a tomato plant is there, one or two plants we grow. Or if any bitter gourd is there, it is a creeper, right? So only one plant we grow, which are where the fruits and vegetables are sufficient only to our family. But whereas farmers, you know about farmers, isn't it? They grow different types of crops. So these farmers, they choose a big land and we call it as field. So in that field, they are going to grow the crops. So they take only one variety of plant and they plant it in the whole area. So if only one type of plant is planted in the whole area, in a large area, we call it as crop. And this process of growing crops in different styles, we call it as agriculture. We call it as agriculture. Growing different types of crops, we call it as agriculture. So here there are kinds of crops. Here they have given three types of crops. So crops are of different kinds. These are, one is the food crop. Then what is second one? The second one is fiber crop. the last one is oil producing crop. So here food crops, most of the people eat food, like in India only there are so many people, but most of the people they eat different kinds of food. Now if you go to the northern side, they eat different food. If you go to east and west side, they eat different kinds of food. And we the people who are towards the southern side, we eat different types of food. So this, why do people eat different types of food like this? Why all the people do not eat the same kind of food? Because in all the places there won't be same type of soil. Okay, in all the places there won't be same kind of soil and same availability of water, air and sunlight. So in whichever region, whichever plants are suitable, they grow those type of plants, and people are habituated to eat that kind of plants. Now if you take towards the southern side, people eat rice. Okay, most of the people eat rice. If you go towards the northern side, they eat chapatis. Okay, they eat chapatis. So whichever side the food is most popular, they grow those plants. And those plants which where most of the people eat, we call them as food crops. So whatever food the people eat, the main ingredient whatever it is, we call that type of food as food crop. Now here the examples of food crop are wheat, another one is rice, then potato and sugar cane. So these are the examples of food crops. The one is wheat, rice, potato and sugar cane, etc. So with sugar cane, potato, most of the people use potato. It doesn't get spoiled easily, isn't it? And with sugar, most of the people use sugar in our daily life, like 3 to 4 kgs in a month they use, isn't it? Then coming to the next one is fiber crops such as cotton, jute and hemp. So these are the fiber crops which they give fiber to us. So cotton, jute and hemp, they are useful for the industrial purpose. The clothes which we are wearing, the furniture which we are using. So these all comes from this fiber crop. So not only food crops, even fiber crops are also very useful to us. Then the last one is oil producing crop. The seeds, okay, the oil producing crops are nothing but from the seeds we extract the oil. So see what are the examples. One is mustard. Mustard is that small black colored one which we put in the curry, isn't it? Those are called as mustard seeds. So from mustard seeds we can produce oil. Then the next one is sunflower. So mustard seeds, sunflower seeds and soya beans. So these are the examples of oil producing crops. From these seeds we are going to extract oil. So most of the people use these oils in their daily lives. So these are the three main crops. One is food crop, that is wheat, rice, potato, sugar cane, etc. Then the next one is fiber crop, that is cotton, jute, hemp. And the next one is oil producing crop, that is mustard, sunflower and soya bean. So here they have given the pictures of the plants. So the first one is the food crop and it is rice. Then the next one is fiber crop and that is cotton. The next one is oil producing crop and this is also an oil producing crop. This is sunflower plant and this is mustard seeds plant. So to grow properly, all crops require sunlight, air, water and fertile soil which could provide them all the nutrients. So as we have already learned that plants, they require sunlight, air and water to grow healthily. So here we are going large number of plants at a time, that is a crop. So for these type of plants, what happens? If they want to grow healthily, if they want to produce large number of seeds at a time, the soil also should be fertile. So what is mean by fertile? It's nothing but the soil should have all types of nutrients. Okay, it should have all types of nutrients in it, where they are very essential for a plant to grow. So some crops, however, may require one of these in a greater or lesser amount. So they are grown in different seasons and in different areas. Now, if you look at these plants which I have shown you here, so these plants, few plants, they do not require much sunlight, but few plants require more sunlight, and few plants they require large amount of water, whereas few plants they do not require water at all. If one time if we put water to the plant also, they grow and they give a healthy food to us. So based on the climatic conditions, like in summer there is very less quantity of water, in winter we have large quantity of water. So based on these things we grow the crops, and even we grow the crops based on the soil. So there are different kinds of soil, you have studied in social studies in the previous year. So based on the soil also we are going to grow different types of soil, different types of crops, so which it suits the soil. Now here there are few crops. So crops like wheat, gram, grown from November to April. So here there are few crops which are grown in winter season, that is from November to April. So they are called as rabi crops. So these rabi crops are grown in winter season. And crops that are grown from June to October are called kharif crops. So these are kharif crops which grow in summer season. So these plants grow in winter season and those grow in summer season. So the examples here are like wheat and gram. Wheat and gram, they grow in rabi crops, that is in the winter season, whereas in summer season the crops are jowar, bajra and maize, rice.
Soils of different types, as
as I already told you. So these plants, if you take for summer crops, if you take like kharif crops, so there are different examples like rice, maize, jowar, spinach, tomato, brinjal. They all grow in summer season, but they all cannot grow in one type of soil. Few will grow in one kind of soil and few they want another type of soil. Like that, they grow in different types of soils. And here also, if you take wheat, gram, cauliflower, cabbage, they all cannot grow in one kind of soil. Few require different kind of soil like loose soil, and few require clayey soil, and few require like a red colored soil. So like the different varieties of soils are there, where they can grow very healthily in such kind of soil. So growth of plants is not only depend on the climatic conditions, but also it is dependent on the types of soil. So here rice and jute grow in clayey soil which holds plenty of water. So the first one is clayey soil. So clayey soil, so this clayey soil will hold so much of water, where rice and jute, they require so much of water to grow. Then turn the page, jowar and bajra grow in sandy soil. So here jowar and bajra, they grow in sandy soil, where this soil will not hold so much of water, that means they require very less water. Then tea plants need moist soil. So these tea plants, they need moist soil. Moist soil means always there should be some kind of rainfall. Okay, so in such areas tea plants are grown, that is in the hilly areas. So tea plants need moist soil and they grow on the slopes of hilly areas. So coconut plants grow in coastal areas. Most of the coconut plants, they grow in coastal areas. So there also there is so much of water. Then maize grow well in dry soil. And here there is one more example of dry soil, that is maize. So here this dry soil, it doesn't hold that much of water. That means maize, it doesn't require so much of water. So these plants, they are found in plains and hills. Then onion and groundnut grow in well drained and sandy soil. So in sandy soil, the examples are onion and groundnut. So these are the different types of soil, and the examples are the plants which grow in these types of soil. So this is for today, and tomorrow we are going to learn about growing good and healthy crops, and even protection of crops and storage of seeds. And your homework is list any five. You have to write any five kharif crops and any five rabi crops in your homework book. Make a table and divide it into two parts. One side you write kharif crops and another side you write rabi crops. Hope you all understood the lesson. Tomorrow